Were we on?
We are on, woman of God. God is faithful. That is her, one of her songs. When I saw her with that song, I said, I'm going to steal that. I'm going to steal that. But then I'll wait to play it until I bring her on here. Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone. I'm Pastor Carol. Amen. And welcome to another Wednesday. Wow. Amen. We are getting ready to have a fabulous time. I already feel it in my spirit. Amen. God is going to move on this platform. Amen. I have a beautiful, beautiful guest on here with me. And y'all already know. Amen. I pray that you have been being safe. Amen. This week with your mask on. I pray you out getting your vaccinations. Y'all saw what I did. Amen. Come on now. I went down. I've got one down and one to go. And I say that God told me to post it openly because he wanted me to encourage God's people as a leader. Amen. Because people are very skeptical. And I understand that because I was skeptical in the beginning. And as I prayed and laid before the Lord, he gave me the clearance. He said, get out there. He said, take a risk. I said, huh? Go read my post on my Facebook page. He said, take a risk. He woke me up. He said, not only take a risk. He said, then, he said, because don't you want to see what's on the other side? He said, this is your reaping season. So take a risk and go on over to the other side because I got blessings for you. Come on now. I said, okay, God, we got to see what's on the other side and take a risk in this season. And so I encourage you to get your vaccinations, amen, and see what's on the other side. God said, and this is prophetic, we are not going back to normal. We're going forward to better. And so if you want to go forward to better, then take a risk and take a chance, amen. My mother is 77, and she got it and came on through. She said, honey, God is in everything. Get your vaccinations. That's what mama said. So again, I encourage you to do so. And also keep wearing your mask and doing what we need to do to stay safe. Amen. And I can tell you, amen, it's going to be good on the other side. And so y'all already know, amen, we're going to thank God for the man of God, amen, on this platform that allows us Queen Esther's to go forward today, amen. None other than Pastor Nick Simpson, amen. Y'all come on, give some hand claps out there on the comments. Give some hand claps for the man of God, amen. And y'all know what I call him. Come on now, because y'all know what Wednesdays are. Hashtag my man. Wednesdays are paydays. Ooh, come on, get into it, baby. Get into it, auntie. Yes, hallelujah. Glory to God. Ain't nothing wrong with it. Amen. Glory to God.
Amen.
And so I thank God for him today. Amen, Pastor Nick Simpson. And you guys know what to do in this game, how to engage. Share, like, love, and comment. And give the woman of God some hearts, because that's her amen corner. She want to see some amens. Amen? Amen. Glory to God. And so I'm getting ready to introduce this powerful woman of God. Amen. Glory to God. She's looking so beautiful today. Hallelujah. I've known her for a long time. I know some of y'all out there viewing didn't know how long I've known her. Amen. But I've known her since 1984.
Long time.
She's gonna pick the story up when I give her the microphone, when I hand it over to her. But right now it's mine, so I get to say what I like about her and all of this stuff. And so I've known her for a long time when I met her. I was working out at a high school. Amen. And she was one of my little coming to the office students, right? And so I'll be on them. I'm gonna let her talk about that a little bit. But I love her then, and I love her now. And I'm so proud to see how she has flourished, how she has blossomed, how she has transitioned into the woman of God that she is today, the mother, amen, that she is today. Amen. And the businesswoman. I'm so happy and proud to still be a part of her life as she elevates into the next sphere of her life, the next level. Amen. I'm happy to be a part of that. I love her. I want her to be encouraged to get on this platform and let God use her. So I want to welcome to this platform the gift according to the gift to the body of Christ according to Ephesians 4:11-12. Amen. And I love you, SGM, and all the people viewing. The gift to the body of Christ according to Ephesians 4:11-12, the gift of the evangelist, Evangelist Branda Kent. Welcome, woman of God. Give us some hand claps. Welcome.
Thank you so much. I'm just really excited to be here on a platform with you. It is amazing. Yes, I remember back when I was in high school, and yeah, you used to call me. She was my counselor. She was my mentor. So we go way back. I truly thank God for you, Pastor Carol, simply because if it had not been for you speaking wisdom in my ear and in my spirit and keeping me on the straight and narrow, I don't know what I would be doing right now. I didn't believe college was in my future, but you would not let me get away. You would not let me stray. You pointed me in the right direction. You held my hand and you made sure I got to that destination. And I want to say thank you. I thank God for you and Pastor Nick for just allowing me to grace this platform with you. I thank God for Shekinah Glory Ministries and just everybody that's watching. I'm really grateful for this. We go way back. And if I haven't told you how much I appreciate you and you have impacted my life, let this be the platform. Well, I scream it to the mountaintop, woman of God, I thank God for you. Amen. I do, I really do.
Amen, you are welcome. I love her. She come, let me tell you, she'd be in the hallway. I said, listen, get to class and then get online, pay attention and start finding financial aid so you can go to college and have a career. It was a path, amen? It was a path to success. And I don't care what nobody say, you need a Carol Simpson in your life, amen?
Yes.
Because if you're going to ever achieve and come to your fullness, and when her talked about this, you need someone. I remember Evangelist B.K. Hinton would come over to the ministry where I came from, and I was real over in the corner in the old sanctuary there, and I had got scooped over to the corner because we had guests, so I'd move on over. I wanted to stay on the end, but I said, well, I'm going to be good because these are my pastors. I got to scoot over, so I get to the end. I'm over by the window, and he said one evening that he was preaching a three-day revival. He said, in order for you to really come to your full potential and everything in you come to full fruition, you have to be celebrated and not tolerated. And that's just it. You have to have someone in your life. And I know I want that. I know you desire it as well as we move forward in this age that we are, to have someone to celebrate you and not just tolerate you. In order for you to blossom in your entirety, to come from your entry from process to purpose, from purpose to destiny. And so I'm still glad that I'm around. Hallelujah. Seeing you in your processes and seeing you going into certain purposes and now getting ready to thrust you, God, getting ready to do into your destiny. I know this for sure, like Oprah Winfrey say. So I'm glad to be a part of that. And if y'all don't know what her, I'm gonna let her tell her subject because it's so awesome. And if y'all hear me preaching on this subject, don't get mad and say she stole that from Evangelist Branda Kent. I did.
No one can do it.
There's nothing new under the sun. So we help each other preach over at the SGM, even if you're on the outside. Come on now, because we're all preachers and we're all gifts to the body of Christ. And so I'll let her pick it up from there. I appreciate you. I love you. Thank you for the beautiful compliments. I thank you and I love you. Amen.
Amen.
Go ahead,
amen.
Woman of God.
Amen. So I was tasked with the title of It's My Story and I'm Sticking to It. It's Whoa. My story and I'm sticking to it. Amen. Amen. Pastor Carol, I don't know where that came from, but I know it was spirit led. And so it's my story and I'm sticking to it. And see, all of us have a story. We come from a place and time. We come from different backgrounds. We come from different places and cultures, and everyone has a story. And so this is just a moment where I'll begin to tell a little bit about my story, but more than anything, I want this to inspire somebody. I want this to enlighten somebody that your story is important, that whatever you've gone through is going to work for your good. Mm-hmm. I want you to know that whatever your story is, begin to learn from it. See, no one knows, because you know what? We put on these masks during the season, but what I've come to realize is that the mask is just not here, because before the pandemic, we were walking around in a full mask, body suit. Mm-hmm. And we begin to act like everything is okay. And even when you're not feeling your best, we want to say everything is okay. And I'm, for one, I've learned the art to say, when someone says, how are you? I'm okay.
Yeah.
I'm okay.
Blessed.
With tears in my eyes, I'm okay.
My.
I'm okay. Mm-hmm. The truth of the matter is, I'm not really okay. And things may not be going as planned, but I will be good. I will be good. And the reason why, because I know a God that's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ever think and imagine. So guess what? I have a vivid imagination. And so when I think, when I'm at my lowest, or when challenges, I'm faced with difficult challenges, that I know that there's a God that I can reach out to, that come there's on. A God that I can call on. Hallelujah. And that he would definitely come to my aid. He inclines his ear to the prayers of the righteous. I'm just grateful to God. And so what I'd like to share is with my story, I want to tell you, there are some things. I've faced some challenges. I've faced some heartaches. I've faced some setbacks. I've had some gains and I've had some losses. But don't you know, no matter what situation you're in, that I can truly tell you that even if it wasn't a good situation, there's people that have come up against me on the job, in the home, in the community. But I'm not a victim. I'm a victor. Because you know what? If you never face obstacles, how do you know if you have the ability to fight? How do you know if your faith is not tested, if you can stand? How do you know that you're able to withstand and most of all, endure? Endure. See, if you ain't never been through anything, and yes, I did say ain't, but if you have never been through anything, then how can you help somebody come through anything? How can you help somebody be delivered? Hallelujah. I'm just going to open up with a simple scripture, because it's going to encompass everything. And it's Proverbs 3:5-6. And we all know that one. Yes. We all know that one. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding in all your ways. Acknowledge him and he will direct your path.
My God.
He will direct your path. I'm a living witness that no matter what happens, if you stay in the face of God, he will direct your path.
Come
your
on.
Path. The Lord says a good man's steps are ordered by the Lord.
Come on.
But he's not ordering steps to the disobedient. He's not ordering steps to the hard-hearted and the hard-headed. He's not ordering steps to people who don't want to have a relationship with him. Hallelujah. So he's not ordering steps until you are in perfect alignment with him. And I'm not saying that you have to be perfect, but we are all striving for perfection. But you've got to have Jesus on the mind. You've got to be willing to submit and to surrender. And so, you know, sometimes when we think that we got it all together, now I'm going to talk about me. I'm not talking about anybody else, but if this helps you, then God bless you. When we think we got it all together and we begin to search ourselves, see, it's good to begin to evaluate yourself.
Come on.
People all over will evaluate you, but there's nothing like you taking a pause to evaluate yourself and understand where you are. Even the Lord asked Adam, Adam, where art thou? It wasn't that Adam, that he didn't know where Adam was. I think it was just a simple oxymoron where he said, Adam, take account of where you are. Where are you and what you're doing? So I say to my sisters and brothers out there, where are you and what you're doing? Is your life lining up? Hallelujah. What are you doing? Have you let situations and circumstances begin to push you back to a place? Have you allowed tragedies and traumas, hallelujah, to keep you bondage? Have you allowed these things to hold you back from the things that God has for you? Hallelujah. But see, I don't want to be in out of season with things.
Come on.
There's times and seasons to our walk and to our life. I don't want to get ahead of God. Mm-hmm. I don't want to get behind God. Glory be to God. I want to be in a place and in a place that he has designed for me to be. And that simply is called destiny. Oh. Hallelujah. See, there's a place called destiny that's designed just for you and no one else can walk in it.
Come
Hallelujah.
On.
There's a place that he has designed for you. And if you're doing things out of place and out of season, then you won't reap the rewards or the benefits. Hallelujah. I think about, hallelujah. Oh. I think about when the fishermen were toiling. They were out in the sea and they began to toil all night. They were trying to catch fish. You know, sometimes we use things in our own ability and we begin to launch out into the deep. The Lord said, launch out into the deep and just begin to go a little further. Go a little further. Hallelujah. But what we do, we don't wait for those instructions. We don't wait for those instructions. What we end up doing is we take matters into our own hand.
Preacher.
I don't know about you, Pastor Carol, but I've taken some matters in my own hand. I've done some things my way. I've said some things that I thought was right in my own natural sense. Hallelujah. I've done these things they all did not work. Hallelujah. For my benefit. Hallelujah. I did not succeed in a lot of things, but I'll tell you what, even in those things that I didn't succeed, but glory be to God, even in a negative situation, God will get the glory, because you know why? You're either going to have a lesson or a blessing. You either going to win or you going to learn. Hallelujah. And I've had some hard lessons that I've had to learn. I've had some hard breaks that I've had to experience. Hallelujah. And I've had some things that have come up to the point of bringing me great pain. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And those, when we are in pain, hallelujah, don't you understand? In that, first, let me talk to you about natural pain.
Come on. Come on.
Natural pain can cause, hallelujah, can cause you discomfort, can cause you anxiety, can cause you agony. It can even alter your character and alter, hallelujah, your very speech.
Come on.
Because y'all know if enough pain hits you, I remember when I was given child, when I was given birth to a child, and I wanted to push as hard as I could, but I could not, the child could not break through. Mm-hmm. And I've seen women who's pushing with all their might and trying to get a breakthrough. And sometimes unchoice words come out. Sometimes unnatural things happen. Sometimes situations take place without your permission. And it's because the pain has taken place and has overtaken you.
Preach!
Hallelujah. But we don't want to live in a place of pain.
Come on.
That pain that you feel, hallelujah, will ultimately take us into a place of purpose. Glory be to God. I always say, you know what? Life without pain, some pain, is probably not life at all.
Right.
Not life at all. Because if you never feel pain, how do you even know if you're still alive?
Ooh, my.
How do you know if you're feeling?
My God.
If you can feel, if you connect.
Come
hallelujah.
On.
If you're numb, you don't even know if you can love. Have you ever been to a place where you become numb from the inside out and
come on.
It seems like you can't receive love and you can't give love.
Come on.
Hallelujah. My I don't God. Know why I'm going this route.
Glory preach.
To God.
Preach.
Glory be to God. But I have to tell you, back to the analogy of the fishermen,
yes,
and what they were going through.
My God.
When we go through certain things and we try to make things happen in our own will, when we try to make things come together at our own time, and we don't consult God in prayer, the Bible tells us to pray without ceasing. Effectual prayer of the righteous much. Hallelujah. That just means that you've got to continue to pray. You've got to be in a place of prayer. When that pain hits, some pain, you have to pray your way through.
Yes.
And if you don't pray your way through, hallelujah, you'll never produce purpose in your life. So everything that I've gone through, glory be to God, yes, I have to tell you that I have no sad song to sing.
Come on.
But I was like that fisherman, those fishermen out at sea, even when they were supposed to go out a little further.
Come on.
And toiling and doing things on my own will and in my own way. Hallelujah. And each time I came up with nothing. I suffered a drought. Hallelujah.
Mama.
Hallelujah. The favor that I thought should have been there, it didn't come through because I was operating in my own self.
Pray.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God. The job, hallelujah, that I was supposed to obtain, and I knew I was qualified, the doors were shut. You can't do things without the Lord. And I know that in the story, what was really interesting to me in the story of the fishermen was that when they came back to sea, when they came back and the Lord told them to go back out a little further, mm-hmm, launch out to the deep.
Yes.
Not did he say launch out into the deep.
Mm-hmm.
He said, go on the right side.
Come on.
Go out on the right side and launch out into the deep.
My God.
Hallelujah. Don't you know anytime you hear about the right hand of God or the right side of God, that signifies power and authority. Hallelujah. They were in a different place trying to catch fish. They were in a different place doing things on their own will, thinking that what they were doing was right. There's a way that seemeth right unto men, but the ending thereof is death.
Praise
certain
God.
Things you have got to be, you have got to be connected to the Lord. And see, one thing I understand is that when they went to the right side, even though they said, we've been out here for a while, Lord, and we caught nothing. We toiled all night. There's no fish out there.
Come on.
Hallelujah. And so that's just like us. We're thinking, there's no blessings out there.
Come on.
There's no relationships out there.
Yeah.
The doors of favor have closed on me. I've toiled and toiled all night.
Come on.
Hallelujah. I'm in a place of pain and there is no healing for my soul. This is how we think.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And the Lord constantly tells us there is a balm in Gilead, but we don't listen to the word of God.
Come on.
When the Lord spoke the word and gave specific instructions to begin to go on the right side of the ship again and cast down their nets, glory be to God. And at the Lord's word, they begin to obey.
At
his word, they begin to obey.
That's it.
Don't you know there's benefits in obeying the word of God?
Come on.
Don't you know that every time you obey the word of God, you can't lose? Hallelujah. Whatever the Lord has promised you this season or last season, woman of God, man of God, I have
Come
to
on.
Tell you that he will not operate outside of his word. He will not operate outside his word. So if God said that you're going to obtain it, you're going to obtain it because his word will not return unto him void.
Come on.
If he said that you're going to get it, that you're going to make it, that you're going to be it, that whatever he's promised you, that's his word.
Yes.
So the disciples said, at your word, we'll go out and we'll obey. At your word.
Woo.
Hallelujah. We'll go out and obey. And they begin to cast down their nets. Hallelujah. And before you know it, in paraphrasing the story, they caught a whole bunch of fish. Hallelujah, that they caught so many fish, hallelujah, that their nets begin to break. Hallelujah, glory be to God. I say to you, no matter what you're going through, even if you tried, I say try again. Even if you failed the first time, go out again. Hallelujah, try God at his word. Don't give up, hallelujah. Don't give up because something is about to break.
Come on.
Hallelujah. I know it seems like things are not lining up. I know it seems like that things are not moving forward. I know it seems like elevation is not taking place. Hallelujah. But things are about to break. Now, see, the enemy wants to give you a breakup or a breakdown. Hallelujah. But God, when he gives you the word and instructions, he will allow you to break out. He'll allow you to break free. Hallelujah. He'll allow things to break open for you. Hallelujah. And that'll be your blessing. Glory be to God. But you've got to take him at his word. Yes. Glory be to God. And I understand now. I understand now when we leaning into our own understanding. The Bible says, first trust him.
Come on.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. If you don't believe and trust the Lord, then how can you really obey something that you don't believe or you don't trust?
Come on.
Glory be to God. It's nearly impossible because if I'm about to fall, and I know you are my only source of support for me hitting the ground, but I don't trust you.
Come on.
Then do you think that I'm really going to take that leap of faith and fall into your arms? Glory be to God. But that's not the God that we serve. Glory be to God. What he tells us is that if we trust him,
come on,
he won't disappoint us. He even says, whatever your cares are, cast them on me. Leave them there. Glory be to God. And then even leave your gifts and stuff at the altar. Begin to come naked before the Lord. Yes. Glory be to God. He wants to do something great in your life. So I want to tell the woman that's struggling with relationship. Yes. I want to tell the woman that's struggling in an abusive situation where she's living with lack. Glory be to God. Where she's feeling like she's been forgotten about. Glory be to God. I want you to know that even if you didn't get it the first time, go out a little further.
Come on
the right side at the word of God and begin to cast your net one more time. Hallelujah. Begin to trust God as you let it down, understanding that he knows and sees much further than we can see. Glory to God. And I'm excited because simply, now that's a little simple lesson, but how do you get to the next level without trusting the Lord? If you're leaning into your own understanding,
come on,
and hallelujah, and not acknowledging God in all your ways, glory be to God. How do you think you have the ability to continue to move forward, to come up a little higher?
How
do you think that you can operate in this life, hallelujah, and in this season without God? It's nearly impossible. Hallelujah, glory be to God. And how do you think the way is being made?
Come on.
Hallelujah. The Bible tells us to press towards the mark.
Come on.
He didn't say just haphazardly make your way. Sometimes, Pastor Carol, you know, we got to be aggressive. Ooh. When we're trying to get to the things of God.
Come on.
Because I was in a place in one point in time in my life where I needed God. Uh-huh. There was nothing in my ability that I can do to make this thing happen.
Come on.
See, when you've been sick unto death and they told you that you got 6 months to live.
Come on.
And that cancer is in your body. There's nothing that you can do. So you might as well trust them.
You
might as well trust him. Glory be to God. And I didn't understand why I was going through it. But I know that God had a plan for my life. And I understand, hallelujah, glory be to God, when certain situations fell apart, that God didn't allow my mind to fall apart. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. He allowed me to keep moving forward. When they came up against me, when friends and even family, you know, because, you know, we experienced some friendly fire. People that actually supposed to be on your team comes up against you. But you know what? Count it all joy. Glory be to God, and know that God will see you through, because you can't give up. You got to keep going. You can't look back. Glory be to God, because I got to tell you, something is about to break. If I would have given up at the point of pain, if I would have given up on every challenge that I've been faced, if I would have given up, oh God, and I'm both shy. Hallelujah. When the pain was so serious that I wanted to throw in the towel. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. I wanted to give up, but I know a man. His name is Jesus.
Preach.
Hallelujah. He can do all things but fail. Glory be to God. And what I couldn't do, I knew that God could do it for me. And all I needed to do was get in a place of surrender, get in a place where I trust him with my whole heart, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that I wasn't afraid to try again, that I wasn't afraid to allow him to make and break and mold me in the name of Jesus. I remember in prayer one day, Pastor Carol, that I began crying and I began asking God, and I know we're not supposed to ask God why, but I began to ask God why all these things were coming all at once. What I do understand is that when things begin to happen, the enemy, when the enemy knows who you are, especially if you're a prayer warrior, you can get a prayer through, he's coming for you.
Come on.
Glory be to God. And it's just to hinder what God has for you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And he began to throw everything but the kitchen sink. And see, here it is. Because sometimes when you're at a place when you can handle things as they come one by one by one by one, he can't get you like that. Mm. Glory be to God.
Come on.
But what he does is he begin to throw things all at once. There's a rhythm to his demise, to the things he throw at you. Like first it's the family, and then it's the children, and it may be the relationship, it may be the job, it may be even your very thought process. Glory be to God. Because you know what? One of the biggest battlegrounds is the mind. So we think when the enemy comes, hallelujah, that he's going to attack with all these things. And he does. We know that he comes to kill, steal, and destroy. Mm-hmm. We understand that. But if he can do a quick work in your mind, don't you know, hallelujah, so as a man thinketh, so is he. So if he begin to change my thoughts about who I am, if he begin to change my thoughts about who I think he is to me, hallelujah, then he can change my very walk. He can change my very speech. I'll begin to then talk defeated. I'll begin to walk as if I was defeated. And it simply starts in the mind. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And that's why I'm glad that the word tells us, let this mind be in you that is also in Christ Jesus. You got to think, hallelujah, on good things, oh God, in the name of Jesus. You can't let them have your mind in the name of Jesus. I remember praying, Lord, have mercy, that if nothing more, God, don't allow me to lose my mind in this thing.
Yes.
You know, the enemy likes to set us up for a breakdown.
Come
hallelujah.
On.
But I do declare that if you trust in the Lord, you won't have a breakdown.
Praise.
But you will have a breakthrough.
Praise,
Lord,
kid.
Be to God. And I am just, I'm at awe at what the way the Lord does things in our lives, in the name of Jesus, that he will never leave us, nor will he ever forsake us. He'll hold our hand, oh God, in the name of Jesus. When I was weak, in my weakened state, and I wanted to give up, he told me that when I'm weak, he's strong. And so I knew at that point, I can just rest in him.
My God.
I could rest in him. Hallelujah. And he held me in the palm of his hand, and he began to minister to me in the midnight hour. Hallelujah. And he began to not, and see, I don't always get the love pats.
Yeah.
See, when God is truly dealing with you,
yeah,
hallelujah, he will correct, he will chasten.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He'll chasten those that he loves.
Come on.
Some people can't be made, they're not pliable. And so in order for a change to take place.
Come on, come on.
Instead of a remote, and it has got to be a clean break.
Oh!
It has got to be a clean break. Hallelujah.
Preach, kid!
Glory be to God. And so one of the things that I realized in prayer that he allowed me to become so broken.
Yes.
He allowed me to become so broken until I had no place to go but up. a hallelujah.
Glory
a hallelujah.
Yes.
And I begin to reach for God. I begin to seek for God. I begin to knock, hallelujah, and I begin to build relationship and not religion. He took me to a place where I just needed to be in his presence. Hallelujah. Lord, I don't care what you do, but God, don't take your spirit from me. Glory be to God. Because I thought my life was going to shipwreck. Glory be to God. But I didn't understand that it couldn't shipwreck because God was on the ship with me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Even Jesus can cause the wind and the storm to obey. And all he had to do is speak to it. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. And all the Lord was asking of me and many women, don't get caught up in what you're going through. Like I said, what you go through is either a lesson or a blessing. Glory be to God. But you're going to learn today. I have to. Hallelujah. You'll never lose. With God, you'll never lose. Glory be to God. You will win or you will learn. You will win or you will learn. Hallelujah. So all things work together for our good, but we've got to trust him even when we can't trace him. Hallelujah. So many people are walking around, Pastor Carol.
Come on.
Hurt.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. They're walking around with a level of pain.
Yes.
And we try to mask it. And sometimes, you know, we're trying to mask that pain till every so often we'll try to do a move or something. And then that limp will come. That limp will come. And you try to straighten it up. You know, so what I'm trying to say is mask what we're going through.
Uh-huh.
Instead of surrendering to God and allow him to heal us and deliver us and set us free. And sometimes we need to be set free from our own self. We need to get out our own self way. Hallelujah.
God.
We need to settle ourselves and begin to get on our face and begin to seek God for the plan that he has for our life. Hallelujah. You can't do it in your own strength.
No.
And I realized that. Hallelujah. But my breaking was for my making. And when I really came to grips with the pain, I understand some pain is necessary. Pain is necessary. But there is also something that's called the recovering pain.
Yeah.
And so think about this, Pastor Carol.
Come on.
When you go and you have surgery.
Come on.
Hallelujah. And after the surgery, you never see after a major surgery or even sometimes when it's not so major that they send you right home afterwards.
Yes.
They don't do that. Yeah. When you leave the operating room, you have to go to the recovery room.
Yes.
The recovering room.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So the Lord is not just going to perform surgery and make things change overnight. Your faith has to be tested. Your faith is tested in the recovery room.
Right.
They got to make sure that everything that you learn in this situation and everything that God has healed and delivered you from, that it has really taken root and that now you can withstand against the wiles of the enemy. When that very thing comes to try you of your faith, that you'll be able to stand. Hallelujah. That we won't just send you home prematurely. Now we know we've done the work. Hallelujah. We know that you've accepted Christ. Now we know we've given you the plan of salvation and you say you want to live for him, but now, hallelujah, that's the original surgery. Hallelujah. That's the cutting open. That's salvation. That's the changing. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And then what happens is that they send you to the recovery room.
Yes.
So now the recovery room is where you're going to get your strength, because you know when you have surgery, you can't leave that room until certain things happen. They got to make sure that you're okay.
Yes.
They got to make sure that you're okay. One of the things that they tell you naturally, so when you're in the recovery room, I got to make sure that your heart rate is stable.
Yeah.
Because if we send you home and your heart rate is not stable,
you
suffer a heart attack.
Oh,
Mama. Hallelujah. Jeez. Hallelujah. We've got to guard our hearts with all diligence. We have to know that we've got to guard our hearts. So that very thing that hurts you, we don't want to perform surgery and send you back to it when your heart has an irregular heartbeat.
Preach. Praise
Glory God. Be to God. Hallelujah. We need to make sure that your heart is stable. We need to make sure, hallelujah, that the fluids are flowing. Glory be to God. That the blood is flowing in all the right places. Because you know, after surgery, if there's a part of your body that's depleted of blood and oxygen, that part will die. Glory be to God. And we don't want any parts of you to die, any parts of us to die, any parts of anybody to die because the blood flow has stopped. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So they test to make sure that there's blood flow to the areas that was operated on. Glory be to God. They make sure that you can stand. They make sure that you can walk. Glory be to God. They make sure, hallelujah, that you won't just be push to the side if anything just come up, or you gotta be stable before you leave the recovery room. And the pain in the recovery room sometimes is just as intense as the initial surgery. And why do I say that? Because the initial surgery, now it may be a major surgery, but what I have to tell you is that there's pain meds, anesthesia. There's things that kind of, you know, help you go through that process while you're getting cut open. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. While God is working on your heart, while He's working on your mind, while He's cutting some of those things away from you, while He's pruning you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. While He's doing a major surgery. Glory be to God. He would have it no other way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The things of your past cannot come and reside in your future. So yes. He's got to even change your appetite. Glory be to God. We got to have an appetite of the things of God. We got to have an appetite. Holy Spirit, help me, God. Yes. We have to have an appetite of the things of God.
My God.
Glory be to God. Our appetite can't be to be back in places that He's delivered us from. Yeah. Even your own stinking thinking. I had to do a whole turnaround. Yes. I had to do a whole turnaround simply because some things God can use and some things He just want to cut. Some things you can nurture and some things you got to neuter. Some people you're going to keep and some people you're going to lose. But it's all within the plan of God if you just let Him use you. Glory be to God. So even when you're going through, understand that you can't give up. You can't give up. Because I say that if you just begin to stay in a place with God, that something will eventually break. That your net will be full of whatever you have. When you launch out into the deep, you'll realize that you were stronger than what you gave yourself credit for. You'll realize that you've never been alone. Hallelujah. Because God will never leave us nor forsake us. Hallelujah. Sometimes in deep water, when we're in deep water and we feel like we're about to sink, the only way we're going to get oxygen is we come to the surface and render up a praise. Hallelujah. Sometimes you need to check where you are. You need to check your faith level. You need to check where you are in your stance and your relationship with God. But sometimes we're so far out in the deep. Hallelujah. Unless we're trusting Him, when we come up, we're just panting for breath. Glory be to God. But when God has given us the word to launch out and we operate in time and season at His command and at His word, there's so many times when Jesus would just send His word.
Yes.
He sent His word.
Yes.
And when He began to send His word is living. His word is life. His word brings about a change. Hallelujah. You cannot operate in the word of God and still remain the same.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Yes. Glory be to God. So when you launch out, you'll realize that there's strength. Launch out into the deep. You'll know that you're stronger than what you thought you were. Glory be to God. And going back to when I was on my knees and I began to ask God why things are happening. And first and foremost, He had to turn the mirror to me and show me me. I had to realize that there were some things that I was doing. See, what we don't want to do is become like, woe is me. It's all about everybody else and you take no part in it.
Glory be to God.
That's not, everybody has a part.
Come on.
In the matter.
Come on.
Glory be to God. And whatever part, whatever He has to take from you. And I've learned to, Lord, don't take it. Just let me know what it is and I'm going to surrender it.
Hello?
I don't have to be broken anymore. I will surrender it. Don't you know when God gets to you sometimes?
Yes.
you have a reverence for God to the point, come on, like, the wrath of God and the hand of God. I do not want to have God upset with me. I do not want to be disobedient like the children of Israel. Hallelujah. He have to give promises to them of what he's going to do and how he's going to do it for their disobedience, for doing all the things that they were doing against the word of God. I don't want to do that. My life, I want my life to just line up. I want to be in a place with God that if God says go to the right, I'll go to the right. If he says go to the left, I'll go to the left, because I know that he has a plan. He has a plan for me. And my God. I remember him giving me this, and this was just profound to me.
Yes.
And it was profound to me because he said, so now out of your pain, I'm going to birth some things if you trust me.
Come on.
At that point, I had no other choice but to trust him. Everything I tried failed. And he began to tell me, in prayer, I want you to get a pet tablet. And see, sometimes God will give us specific instructions.
Yeah.
Just like he told the fishermen, you go to this location and you do this. Mm-hmm. And when you follow those instructions, then there's blessings and success in following and being obedient to God. Mm-hmm. And he began to tell me, get a tablet. I want you to write it. I want you to write your pain. I want you to write. And I'm an advocate of journaling. I understand that, but I've never really wanted to get a separate book and just write all the things that has bothered me or come up against me or hurt me.
Right.
But you've got to release it.
Got
Hallelujah.
To.
And see, God, even when we think that nothing is happening, he's working it out for our good. He's working behind the scene and he's orchestrating our affairs. And he said, I want you to write your pain and write the things that hurt you. And then he said, what was the kicker? He said, and when you're done, I'm going to take it all and I'm going to turn it into poetry.
Yes.
I said, well, what does that mean?
Come on.
What does that mean? And I began to like think about, what does that mean to me? If he's going to take pain and make it to poetry, poetry is a rhythmic, almost like a rhythmic love story.
Yes.
Some poems are really nice to read. So how do you take pain and turn it to something that can be used and something that's pleasurable and something, hallelujah, that's beautiful. See, I like poetry, and poetry to me, it puts me in a mind frame. Some poetry touched the inner part of my soul. Like it can bring, when I'm feeling down, the word of God, it's like poetry as well. Go to Proverbs, go to Song of Solomon, go to the Psalms, some of those prayers are like poetry to me. He told me to begin to write it and he'll turn it to poetry. And so I thought poetry, when I looked at poetry, it says it means to create, even in your pain, to create or to make. So I'm writing my pain and you're going to create and make something beautiful. The word poetry comes from poem, and the Greek word for poem is poema, meaning masterpiece, a poem, a work of art. So when I got the revelation that the pain that you suffered, I want you to recognize it. I want you to feel the very effects of it, because it won't be with you always. I want you to put it on paper. Hallelujah. I want you to write it and make it plain. Yes. I want you to shame the devil so that you can have a reminder, hallelujah, of with the state of mind and the state of being you were in. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, and it reminded me, I'm a very visual person, but when I saw it, it was like, I'm going to take that pain. I'm going to ball it up. And I'm going to make it into something beautiful. So even in my pain, he's creating, hallelujah, a masterpiece, a work of art. Even in your pain, that the Lord is giving you something tangible to be. Now, our lives are written epistles. So now that pain that has been taken away from me and the poetry and how he's created and molded me, hallelujah, now I have something to give. Now I have something to speak on. Now I'm able to share life to my brother and my sister to let you know that if the pain don't kill you, it'll surely make you better. And God is not calling you to death, because he wants you to live and not die. That he will take the things that were meant to destroy you and begin to use it for your good. Glory be to God. It's a love story to me. Hallelujah. Yeah. and it works together for my good. My. So I just want to tell you to keep going. Don't give up. Keep going, because something is about to break. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. But even in that, my story is my history. Glory be to God. It's a thing of my past. But I surrendered my life to God, and when I gave it all to God, my story then translated into his story. Hallelujah. My story became history, and now I'm living his story. And now, because it's his story for my life is lining up. Hallelujah. There's favor opening up for me. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. There's doors opening up in the name of Jesus. I was able to receive my healing. I was able to be delivered and set free. We cannot think that it's everybody else that need a deliverance. Sometimes you need to be delivered from some things within you too. Hallelujah. Yes. Even from the negative self-talk, even from the doubt and the worry. Glory be to God. But I want you to stand tall, and I want you to be able to listen to the word of God. And when he tells you, I want you to be obedient. And I'm talking to those who are on Facebook. Don't give up. Don't give up, because something is about to break. He's writing your story. Hallelujah. But we're just living it live and living color. We live out our story as he's changing it, and he's making it, and he's molding it. And as he began to reshape it and rewrite it, hallelujah, he'll take those broken pieces and make it into a masterpiece. Hallelujah. So some of those things, those broken pieces, hallelujah, he'll put them together, and you'll become that one perfect masterpiece. And I just really thank God. I thank God for everything that we've gone through. My story is insignificant. It's all gains and no losses. It's something that we have to endure. Your own story, you got one. Hallelujah. My story is rich. I want to pose a question. What is your story?
Come on.
And can you tell it? Now, can you really truly tell the story when you're still living it? You've got to come out and face the book, and now I can read it. And then guess what? When I've been delivered, when you've been set free, when you've been healed, he don't have to put it in the book, because your life is that book. And so when men and women are looking at you from afar and wanting to know how to get out, they can say, oh, well, I know she went through that. I know she was healed through this. And it just simply allows them to see God, not you. But our lives are written epistles for every man to read. And what we want to do is we want to walk circumspect. We want to walk. We want to be aligned. We want to walk upright before the Lord so that when they see us, they see God. I don't need them to see me, because hallelujah, in my flesh there dwelleth no good thing. And I'm subject to error. I'm subject to fall down. Hallelujah. But I got enough sense, and I trust the Lord. That in my own understanding, hallelujah, I can't make it. I can't lean into my own understanding, but I gotta trust God, hallelujah, in all my ways, and let him direct my path. So I'ma say to you and everybody out there on Facebook, get up, try again. Don't give up. Something is about to break. Launch out into the deep. Let God, hallelujah, do the work inside you. Your story is rich, and it needs to be told. Hallelujah. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Hallelujah. I give God the glory, because what you see right now, I don't look like what I've been through. That's because his story is being made within me.
My God.
I give God the glory.
My God. Go ahead and say a word of prayer, woman of God, before I make any comments. Go ahead and say a word of prayer over what you have ministered, my God.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, Jesus. We just thank you. We thank you for your word, Father. We give your name the glory, the honor, and the praise, oh God. We thank you for orchestrating our footsteps, oh God. We thank you, oh God, for your grace and mercy and aligning us together, oh God. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. We thank you for strength, oh God, to get through anything that has tried to hinder us, stop us, block us, oh God, in the name of Jesus. God, we ask for forgiveness, oh God, and we even repent for those things, oh God, that are hindrance in our lives, oh God. God, we just ask that your hand be stayed upon us, oh God, that you continue to lead and guide us, oh God. God, we thank you, oh God, for the spirit of obedience, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I pray that you cover this word, God. I pray that men and women will understand that they don't have to give up, that there is a breaking of day coming, oh God, that if we obey you and cast down our nets at the appointed time and in the right place in the destination, that there will be blessings and favors and open doors, oh God, that our nets will too begin to break, Lord. And we just give your name the glory and the honor, Lord God. We thank you, oh God, for those who are online this day, oh God, this time, this hour. I pray a special prayer for Pastor Nick and Pastor Carol, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that you may keep your hand up on them, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord God. Increase them, oh God. We thank you for the oil on their life, God, and we give your name the glory and we give your name the honor. We thank you for being with us, oh God, and taking us through it and allowing us to be victorious in this and all things. In Jesus' name, amen.
My God, what a rich word. Almost tore this studio up. But I said it's not fair because people can't hear if you get out of control, Pastor Carol. So subdue, come under, and exercise the spirit of temperance.
Amen, amen, amen.
Because when I say, my God, that's your story and you're sticking to it. You better get a story out there. It's your story. Like I said, his story become her story so she can continue to live her story as it proceeds, as she processes through what God is doing. What a mighty, mighty word. The natural pain, no gain. And I love how you talked about when you're in that recovery room after the initial pain of the surgery, and she talked about the different things that had to be done to you in the recovery room to check your heart rate and make sure everything is under control before they send you home, your temperature and all that. And then they give you the pain medication to control the pain, not get you out of pain, just control it, because God wants to continue to deal with you after the surgery and the recovery room so you can get it. What he rooted out so you can get it. And you know what that pain medication is called? Grace.
Yes.
It's sufficient.
Yes. Yes.
What a mighty word. Take that grace home. When you get done purifying and cleansing and washing you, come on now, guess what will happen? You'll come out fully recovered. Come on now, gain your mind back, your senses, and move forward like the woman of God says, because something is about to break. Don't y'all get mad when I preach that something is about to break. Don't get mad at it. Just say amen and amen. What a mighty word, woman of God. What a mighty word. We have to trust him. And look at this. She said this. Trust him because he can. Because how can he say you got to trust him? But how can you trust something you don't obey? I mean, how can you obey something you don't trust? Mm-hmm. And she really, if y'all listen, before we do some household stuff, and I'm going to keep you on here too, woman of God, because I got another song for you. She picked this one out with our other part of the media team, my son. She said, what song is that, Lynn? And he told her, she said, yeah. I know. Oh, yeah, play that. Come on now. And let me tell you something. She said something that was so crucial in this message that you have to do. The word is obedience. She didn't say you got to like it. Y'all know I talk about it all the time. But she went over to, if ye be willing and obedient, you'll eat the fruit of the land. That is the core foundation of everything that she built up in the story. Her story is the obedience. If you put the obedience in there and get out of your own way, then you'll get out of God's way. And then you can get your blessings from the process and the pain. You can get it. Either you're going to learn. Like she said, you're going to learn today. She talked about the master. You're going to learn today, but it got to be through your obedience and your surrendering in order for God to give you that next level. Get a story. Know your story. Stick to it. Don't let the devil move you all over the place with foolishness. because he's done me the same way. God said the word is a light unto our path and a lamp unto our feet. And you know what I've done? Because I didn't like the path, even though it was lit up, I didn't like certain things that was on the path because I wanted my way. So I veered off and picked up some more devils that I had to contend with because I wanted my way. And it caused so much more pressure on me because I wanted to have my way. So God says, okay, eat your Burger King burger and you... And you're going to get hurt, Pastor Carol. You'll get hurt, Carol, and I did.
That pain will make you, though.
Yeah, because that pain, it turned into a Romans 8:28, and we know all things work together for the good. The devils he put on me to make me, and the devils I ran off the beaten path over there in the darkness and picked up, got them. And so, oh my God, but it helped me. Thank you, woman of God. And you guys, thank you so much, woman of God. What a powerful word. You hear me, Evangelist? Powerful word. Listen, you guys already know what to do. Go to our website at www.shekinahglorylv.org and press that donate button and plant a seed into this word tonight. We appreciate you. We thank you for viewing. And remember, it's her story. She's sticking to it. What about you? Amen. Even when it gets hard, stick to it, stick with it, and go with the flow with God, and you'll come out victoriously. Amen. As the victor and not the victim. We love you. God bless you all. Until next time, thank you, woman of God. We'll see you on the next Wednesday. Wow. I'm Amen. Pastor Carol. Amen. God bless you.
Around the heavens, waters down the sea, Creator of the sunshine and the storms around me, but still they laugh and mock. Oh.